Hi, I'm Scott Thompson.
And welcome to Postmortem.
I love being on Hannibal, but let's face it, my character Jimmy Price is not exactly the most important guy in the show. But I found a way to remedy that. I've hijacked Hannibal's office to give myself more screen time. Oh, and of course to talk about the show, because apparently that's why we're all here. Today on Postmortem, we're talking to food stylist Janice Poon. We're ready for you, Janice. Yum. Hello, Janice.
Hello, Scott.
Come on in.
So nice to see you.
Nice to see you. Oh, good. Put your packages there. It's so nice to finally meet you. I mean, we've never really spent any time together.
No, what a wonderful opportunity. I love your place.
Well, thank you very much. So how long have you been a food stylist?
Well, I was an art director in an ad agency.
Okay.
And three of my accounts were food accounts.
Okay.
And I had a shoot with hundreds of buns, thousands of chips, zillions of burgers. And
right.
We spent the first 3 hours going through everything.
Right.
To find the perfect bun, you know, all of that.
Right.
And when it came to when becoming a food stylist,
right.
being inspired to be a food stylist, it was when I saw the guy choosing all the long fries.
Right.
And putting very thin skewers down each one so they would stand up nicely in that little red box.
Right.
And when I saw that, I thought, you know what? That's a job for me. Duplicity, artistry.
Right.
Perfect.
Skewering long, thin things.
Yeah. Exactly.
Now, are you a carnivore?
Absolutely. Yeah.
Can a true foodie not be a carnivore? Can a vegetarian be a true foodie?
I think so.
What about a vegan?
You know something? Chacun son goût. Everybody should make their own way in life. And if you don't think it's right to eat animals.
Right.
I mean, it's all deciding, isn't it?
Right.
Hannibal draws his line somewhere after people.
Right.
Most people draw their line somewhere after cow.
Right.
It's all just degrees of things.
Right.
I mean, what we eat and what we don't eat is something that is very highly codified without our civilizations and within our era. I mean, there was a time when it was perfectly, you know, perfectly on to, as it was an honor to
eat somebody. Do you think that's what Hannibal's doing when he's eating people, that he's actually taking in the qualities of the people that he's eating?
My take on that is that he doesn't really want he is a man fully qualified for everything.
Right.
I think in his mind, he is perfection.
Right.
And the people that he's cooking and eating, it's all in the cooking, really. He's refining them. You know, they've done some terrible thing.
So he's making them better.
He's eating
by being digested by him.
Really by cooking them.
Okay.
I mean, it's my interpretation,
right.
because I'm a cook.
Right.
I think that's how you refine. Cooking is refining.
How does Maz like working with the food? Like, is he a foodie? I just assume he is because he looks so elegant and he's Danish.
I think that he's very interested in food and he's very interested in the way it tastes. So if that's a foodie, then yes.
Do you like working with Maz?
I adore it.
Can he cook or is he faking? Because he looks like he's really... Did you train him in how to be elegant and cutting and all that sort of thing?
I did train him, but I can't take credit for it because he's a natural. He just...
Because he's a dancer, so he's very graceful mm-hmm. and balletic. Mm-hmm. And I think when he cuts and stuff, mm-hmm. I find it very... Can I say erotic? He is. He's an erotic man and a sensual man.
A sensual man.
I think he could talk me into eating anything.
And he may yet.
Speaking of that, I brought you something. Because I know I said I wasn't a bit of a foodie, but I was being a little disingenuous. Because I have something here. I have some Hannibals.
Yeah.
Yes, and they are. And they're modeled on Mads bits.
Oh, bits.
Let's call them bits.
Okay, sorry.
Let's call them Danish bits. And
do they spurt blood? I'm not interested in
No, they're just regular.
They just
take a bit. They spurt prostate fluid.
Oh.
I mean, I don't even know if they're
malicious.
Oil. Is there even a fluid in prostate? I don't even know. Like.
No, it all
oil.
Goes kind of...
Like a ball. They're not ball bearings, are they?
No.
This is good.
Mmm, delicious.
Well, thank you very much for joining us on Postmortem. My guest has been Janice Poon, everybody.
Oh, it's been swell.
You've been fantastic.
I'm gonna cook you all up for dinner.
Yeah.
Everybody come on over.
See you next time.